Hello students, this is biobotany class by Mini. So today's our topic is genetic recombination in bacteria. As I told you that I'll describe the sexual reproduction. In last video I teach you about the asexual reproduction, which is through the binary fission, and that is the sexual reproduction. And now, but in bacteria there is no sex organ, so but there is present genetic recombination. Because of this genetic recombination, bacteria possess sexual reproduction. So first, the scientist is Statham and Lederberg. In 1947 he described the genetic recombination in E. coli, Escherichia coli, and they said there is a genetic material interchange, that is called the genetic recombination. It means that having genetic material interchange, and this is called sexual reproduction. So sexual reproduction, basically there is three kind of sexual reproduction. The first process is conjugation, number two is transformation, number three is transduction. So first I'll describe the conjugation process. The first one is conjugation. So in the conjugation process, there is two kind of cell. The first one is donor cell, which is F positive and which has fertile cell. There is two kind of cell. Donor cell, it means which is for F1 positive and which is called fertile cell, or even you can say male cell, M-A-L-E, male cell. Okay, male type, it's called male type. And other is recipient cell, it means that is F negative and that is female type. So you can see there is no sex organ, but that have two different kind of cell, donor cell and recipient cell. So now come to the structure. So there is a donor cell, F positive, and there is recipient cell, which is F negative. Now before fusing the donor and recipient cell, they replicate they start replication and make a duplicate copy of chromosome. That is the chromosome, that is chromosome, and that one is effector of donor cell. So before fusion they start replication and make a, after replication they make a duplicate copy of chromosome. It means there is another duplicate copy of chromosome, which is called duplicate chromosome, and that will be the older, it means parental chromosomes. In the third step, as you can see, then donor cell effector fuse with the recipient cell. That condition is showing the donor cell and recipient after fusion. And after fusion, they form a conjugated tube-like structure. Conjugated tube-like structures like this. Conjugated tube-like structure, and there in the recipient cell, the effector enter in the conjugated tube. It means donor cell chromosome enter into the recipient cell, and it's make like conjugated. On the basis of this is called conjugation. It means they making the conjugated tube-like structure and transferring the in the recipient cell. After the fusion of donor and recipient cell, the new genetic hybrid is formed. The complete whole process is complete into the 110 minutes. It can, but this process is very, you can say, it takes very less time to continue. Because of that, the multiplication did not complete. Yeah, you can say multiplication. Partially happened, and this is called conjugation process. And in this process, what will be the result? The new genetic hybrid is formed, or you can say that is the recombinant genetic material is formed in the process of conjugation. And first we said it has happened in E. coli, and rather than E. coli, in which cell conjugation happened? The conjugation process happened except E. coli, Pseudomonas, Pseudo, P-S-E-U-D-O, Pseudomonas, Salmonella typhi, cause typhoid, and Vibrio cholera. Also possess Vibrio cholera, Pseudomonas, Salmonella typhi. Pseudomonas causes pneumonia. Salmonella typhi causes typhoid. Vibrio cholera causes cholera disease. It means conjugation process happened in the Pseudomonas except E. coli. Include E. coli. Because first discovery happened in the E. coli, na? So E. coli include E. coli, it happens in Pseudomonas, Salmonella typhi, and Vibrio cholera. That is the complete process of conjugation. Once again, there is two different donor cell, F positive and negative. Before fusion, they start replication. After replication, they make a new duplicate copy of chromosome. That is the duplicate, and after that, they make fusion, they make a conjugated tube, and the F factor enter into the recipient cell, and they make a new genetic hybrid chromosome. This complete process is called conjugation.